So what's up everyone, and right now I know it's kind of awkward, but welcome back guys. And right now I'm going to pick up my grammar, as I know it's kind of different. I told you guys I'm gonna do something else, and now I'm showing you that I'm doing something else. Yeah, I know, but this journey starts in the morning, whereby I'll be picking up my grammar, and then from that point of view we'll then from there on pick up a friend of ours and we'll go to that Dar es Salaam zoo. So that's how it's going to be. And now I'm in the car, I'm gonna pick up, though we are not gonna be using a private from here where I am until Dar es Salaam zoo. I'll show you the journey, how it's gonna be. So this is how it started. By the way, this is among the things that I had a plan to do since long time ago, and yeah, like I really had that plan of doing it for like 3 weeks ago. I even told my cousin about it, but we weren't sure of the day to go, so that's why we had to cancel it. And then today also I'm gonna pick up someone else, not my cousin, for a reason, because if you guys don't know him, I think for those who are following up, you remember that moment when we went to sit in Pugukazi Mzumbi, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, so today we're gonna be doing that, and yeah, that's it guys, and welcome back. It's been a while since when I vlogged. I don't know how does this feel, but so welcome back. My name is Oscarana, and today I'm gonna be telling you the pros and cons of going to Dar es Salaam. So sincerely, I think there's so many things that I could talk about, but I just decided to make this video and specify them on the pros and cons, and at the end of time I'll tell you, like, is it worth it really going there and what you should expect, because I think most of us really do travels for new experiences. So stay tuned and watch until the end to understand what's happening behind that. Number one, I'll start with the pros, because I think the cons are already known. Or should I start? Okay. Oh my God, what should I start with? Okay, I'm gonna start with the cons and then I'll come to the pros. I think that would be a better idea, like, rather than the pros and the cons. So let's save the good stuff for later. So the first thing is poor transport system. Now, I really tell this, like, oh my God. Now, before I even start telling you what happened behind, a short story before I tell you the pros and cons, I just want to say that I had another plan of going to get my grandma and then coming back, which is something that I'm going to be showing you before. I think so, I might have already shown, depends with the video. So I think I'll show you that, because that was the plan. Then we go, because I didn't go alone, I went with my friend. So that's what happened exactly. If I'm not going to be showing the video, then I probably have to explain this, so as I'll be showing that one and then showing the video for really what happened. But that's exactly, that's why even on the picture, I think you have seen half of those people who have actually checked on the Instagram. I posted some of the pictures from the Dar es Salaam zoo, and yeah, that's the thing. So getting back to the video, that was just a little brief of the exact day of what happened, really, of going and coming back, and that I was not alone. My voice even getting over. So right now I'm going to be telling you the, okay. So now I'm going to start with the cons of this Dar es Salaam zoo trip. So the first thing was poor transport system. So on the side of the transport, sincerely, you need to be ready, because when you go there, you literally have to go by transport, like the normal public transport, which is good. And just by starting, if you haven't seen the other video of the one that I did of transport system in Tanzania, you should use that and to guide you. So the thing is, when you go there, you have to use a ferry transport. Then from there you're gonna have to use a public transport, like the old public transports. But the thing, the poor transport system that I'm talking about is when you're coming back, because when you come back there are less cars and less public transport coming back this way in Dar es Salaam, because the other side is Kigamboni and this side is Dar es Salaam. So when you literally want to come back, I would advise you to get a private, but that's not the best too, because the only way to survive through this and use less amount of money is using public. And when you use public, when you come back, you need to time yourself so as the moment that you come back, it's not that evening, because if it's around I think it's around 5 and 6 there, it's very bad, because you'll not get you'll not be able to get a good security system. So it's more of like the yin and yang, like the good inside the bad. Anyway, so that's the second. Like the third one, it's kind of something that I really have to be honest about, and it's there is expensive food right there. Expensive food. And to be honest, I didn't go there without eating. I had to eat before. That's what I always do. Like, I try to eat outside of the tourist place, and that's something that you should know. I'll make another video of the things that you should, like, be careful before traveling. So sure you subscribe, and especially in Tanzania. I haven't been traveling much, but I can share some of the experience basing on what I think and basing of what I've experienced. So the first thing, as I said, the poor transport system. And the second one, it's not for enthusiasts, for travelers who are not into wildlife. And the third one, it's expensive food. So probably, I think there'll be more which actually on the cons, but those are the actually main things that I've seen on my side. I don't know, other people would say something else, but anyway, if you have gone there and you want to share experience, be sure to comment down in the comment section, so as I know what you think. And just tell me if you think these would be the cons to your side. So yeah, those are the cons. Now getting to the pros part. Now there's so many of the pros, because I think that's why it's even there. Like, if it would have been like a lot of the cons more than the pros, even it could have been like taken away. But a pro tip before I finish up with the cons, I think a lot of people have actually said something about this. There's some zone in the network and the social media. I checked that before I went, like Jamie Forum and others. And they're saying like the place is it's not well kept, which is kind of true and also kind of bad, and also not that as it will distract you, but somehow yes, the environment is not that much well taken care of. But doesn't mean you won't enjoy the fact that you're there. Like, you want to go to the places where wild animals are kept, and you want to have carpets or something. I don't really get the point of what they were trying to say, because you're telling me that the environment is not well taken care of, but as I'm saying, it's a wildlife place. I don't know. Anyway, just a comment or a compliment of what I think. Just let me know too what you're thinking on the comment section. So the other thing is, I want to talk of the pros. So the first pro, we're getting to the pros part now. We have I think four, if not five, pros. So the first pro thing is cheap travel trip. Like, if you are looking for like a place to just go and have fun and just check it out, like check out the environment, going there was going to be like the best thing that you will not regret, because it's cheap. And if you use especially the transport system of the public transport system, it's gonna be cheap. And I did a public transport system video, so if you want to check that out, though I didn't mention all of them, there's some of the system that I didn't, but the basic ones, I just mentioned them all and I showed them what you should expect on there. And yeah, that's it. So like, it's cheap, it's really cheap. And the entrance, it's for those guys who are actually Tanzanians, or people who are Tanzanians just like me, it's very cheap. It's around 5,000 Tanzanian shillings. I'll try to convert them into US dollars and keep them there. And also for those who are foreigners, it's I think it's double the price, something like that for foreigners. I'm gonna just leave them here just to be sure that 100% of efficiency. I'm just gonna leave them there. So that's the thing. And also a pro tip on the pro side, when you go there, they'll tell you like they have these people who are actually tour guides, whereby they're not paid with that place, but if you actually, it's tipping, it's more of the tipping thing. So if you really think that is really good for you, because it's like 10,000, even more if you want to give them more. But trust me, I'm telling you, I think it was more of a personal issue. I don't think if I would tip the next time I go there. You ask me why? To be honest, I think they said that it was a very long distance that we're gonna walk through, and to be honest, it's not even that long. Like, not the way it was mentioned it to be long, but it is not that long. So you could literally walk on your own and see the environment, because there are some places that they're written, like you could read and you could know what's happening. But if you want more elaboration, I don't know, people would pay for that. But personally, I wouldn't. Next time I go, if I knew I'd gone to the first time and understood that, I couldn't pay for that. So for my advice, if you think that it's not necessary to increase your budget, don't pay for that and don't tip out. I'm not saying that I'm being bad for those who are working there, but I'm just being honest. I'm sorry guys, just gotta be honest. So yep, now that's the first one, the cheap travel. Now let's get to the second pro. So for those guys who are actually asking what's the second one, this is the second one. The second pro is that in that place, it's super safe. Like, even the other time I was saying on the cons that you could go back late and then getting problems with the transport. But the good thing is that it's safe, even though it's evening. Because even the workers of there, like, they go back to their homes. You ask me, like, how do they go back? They go back with the evening times, whereby even the transport is hard, but it's still safe. Like, it's 100, not 100 exactly, 99% I would give, or 95% it's safe. So even if it's evening, you don't have to worry. Like, maybe, like, something will happen to you on the road or something like that. You don't have to worry. It's safe, for sure. It's safe. Like, you should literally have no problem with that. It's super safe. You can even go back at your home or your place that you rent in the evening time. So with the safety part, I give it in number two as a pro. And then let's go to the third one. The third one, it's for new experiences. For example, if I had gone there and I didn't experience before, like climbing a horse or climbing a camel, I experienced it back when I was a kid. So literally, things that I experienced when I was a kid, I don't really consider them as experience. You need to experience them right now, like when you're grown up, and or even if you're a child, probably you're watching this, I don't know, depends who's watching, but you should experience them again to really feel the thing, like to understand what's happening. That's according to me. That's my perspective. That's my perception. So, as I said, okay. So that's the thing. That's the third one. Like, it's a place where you can experience the camel climbing and the horse climbing. And for kids, for sure, if it's for a kid, there are those places whereby they have swings, whereby the kids could play. So it's not a thing that you can only experience as an adult, but even a kid could go there. If you have a kid, your child, you could go with them and they could literally be happy and enjoy the moment. It's not only who is going to enjoy. And the question is, that's something I just got in mind, a little bit of a tip. I always give my tips on the moment I give my video. I don't really leave them for the end, and I don't like that because you may even forget them. Like, sometimes you may think that, is it really good for travelers? For people who are going to travel to Tanzania, I think it's a good thing to come and visit that place, because I think it's more enjoyable, because you can find those things in the other places. But for some trips, if you want to make them, like if you have to go to Mikumi, and if you haven't known Mikumi, it's a national park in Tanzania. So if you have to go to those places to see the lions, probably you could go there, but it's going to take you time, like until you plan. It's going to be more expensive. Things will become more complicated, but those for the zoo, you could just go there and then you could figure out and see them. So see, and get a good experience, like climbing, things like that. But it's not for hiking. There's no hiking in the salaam, so please get that. Some of them, I've seen someone commenting that there's hiking in social media, which there isn't. So get that in mind too. I just wanted to say that out. Now the fourth one is it's for enthusiasts who are actually looking for seeing wildlife. Now it's kind of the vice versa of a con that I said before, that for the person who is traveling to see wildlife and he or she wants to spend less, I think that's a good option you have right there. Like if you're in Tanzania and probably you came from Uganda or you came from whatsoever country, doesn't mean it must be Africa anywhere, and I'm just looking forward to like see some wild animals, as Africa is known for wild animals. I'm not saying that we are wild animals, no comment, and I'm just saying that it's a good place you could go and see wild animals rather than going to Mikumi, which is going to consume you like tons and tons and tons of like amount of money and out of things. So I think those are the four pros that I really thought that I could tell you. And if you have any other, oh my god, mosquitoes. So if you have any other like pro which is an advantage, so if you have any pro, just let me know down in the comment section. And if you have ever gone there, just let me know. So I'll repeat the pros if you didn't. So the first pro was it's cheap travel, the second one it's safe, and the third one is for people who are actually looking for new experience, like climbing horses and stuff, climbing camels. And also the fourth one is for enthusiasts who really want to see animals. Okay, on the con side, and okay, I'll keep, these are the pros, right? And these are the cons. So the con side, poor transport system while coming back. And the second one, it's not for enthusiasts who are actually not looking for seeing wild animals. I don't really get that. For those who are actually not looking to wild animals, Like, they don't want to see wild animals in their travel. They shouldn't go there. There's nothing else you are going to get there. And the last one is the expensive food. And they will literally sell you something. Thank you. Thank God I even remember this. They'll sell you these kind of granuts, and they'll tell you that it's essential for them to, like, for you to give the, to give those monkeys, and they'll sell you for, like, probably, it's 1,000. Is it 1,000? Something like that, if it's not 2,000 Tanzanian shillings in US dollars. Okay, it looks cheap to most of you guys if I turn it to US dollars. I know that, but to us, it's our currency. With that kind of amount of money buying that, really, it's expensive, and I don't buy that. They convinced me. They didn't make me do that, but they convinced me, and really, I was gonna not buy it, but I don't know how they even managed to convince me I bought that. So, for good advice, don't buy that. They kind of give you granite and stuff to give the monkey, to attract the monkey. Yes, you give the monkey, but really, it's not even worth it. You can even go and give something else. Like, we gave the grasses to those antelopes. Were they antelopes? I think so. And they came and they ate. We took pictures. That's a good thing. But the bad part is that also I remembered, and we were not able to, like, hold the cubs and take pictures with the cubs, because I had that services available too. You know, sometimes you may go in the place and expecting something and you don't get it for real. But anyway, that was all we have for today, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. And I think if anything I've forgotten, I just let you know on the section there. I always write some things. I hope people are reading. And if you have anything else, hope you have seen also my other videos of traveling. Until me next time, guys, enjoy, and let me know if you have gone to this place or you have a plan of traveling to Africa. I do wish to travel so many places, but it's just time. But I hope things will be getting well, and I'll be doing my things as I planned. Until me next time, be sure to check out my other videos, and peace out. Bye bye. A little bit earlier to be done, like, I don't know, it was supposed to be a video that I was supposed to make like a couple months ago, but somehow I didn't make it. And these are my mic test one. I don't know, I think it's just a simple setup.